I'm being cheeky here. I'm asking you to help me decide what the future of the channel will be. But being as it's you who have got this channel where it is, I think it's only fair that you have some say in where it goes next, right? Hello, gorgeous. How are you doing? In this one, I'm going to be talking more about weight loss again. Yay, old weight loss. Face work. I've been having some filler done. Impending surgery. And I'm doing this off the cuff, a little bit unscripted, as you do, because, you know, it's hard to read a script when you're driving the car. So, what is going on? Weight loss. I am down to my lowest again. Well, here's the thing. I don't know how many times I've said this now. I am yet again at a new lowest weight. I'm now 12 pounds away from my target. So I originally set a goal weight of 16 stones. And this is not counting fat I've lost because I've gained muscle back. Total loss and fat loss, it gets a little complicated. Long story short, I never thought I'd be able to get to 16 stone, but I'm still losing about 4 to 6 pounds a month. It's slowed down, but it's still coming off, which is amazing. And that's not counting the surgical weight loss that I'm also getting from excess skin removal. Oh my God, like, I'm freaking out a little bit, but it also means, and I think I've got more to lose. So 16 stone was my goal, but I think that I'm going to be able to get under that. I think I'm possibly aiming for 14, maybe 15 stone, somewhere around there. It's really hard to, I'm 6 foot and I do bodybuilding. I carry a lot of muscle mass. When you look at the ideal weight for women at 5'11", etc., it shows me at like 11 stone. Well, there's no way that A, having my body developed as a male for quite some time means I'm a little bit heavier. And even though the hormones and drugs have pretty much changed all that, I'm still large. And also the fact that I carry a lot more muscle than average means that puts it up completely. So, 16 was the goal. Let's see what happens when we get there. But now that I'm getting there, I think I'm carrying, from a fat percentage wise, it's still relatively high, which tells me that I've got more fat to lose. But that's okay. I'm kind of enjoying it, to be honest with you. And it also means I'm still quite a way away from being stage ready. That's probably not going to happen until, next year. But that's fine. Bear in mind that I'm still losing weight, even though I've barely been able to go to the gym in the last 6 weeks because of the back-to-back surgeries I've been having. I haven't trained anywhere near my usual levels of intensity. And so that's really slowed down my weight loss and my toning. Well, next week, next Tuesday, I'll be back in theatre having my bum done. And that's kind of the last of the big procedures, which means that in a few weeks' time, all being well, I'm going to be able to start getting back to the gym properly. The same sort of levels of training I was doing at the beginning of the year, and that makes me happy. So I think all things considered, considering I haven't been able to train, I've been lucky if I've been getting one session a week in, and even those haven't been intense by any stretch. To be able to go back to my 10 sessions a week routine soon, it's on the cards. And I'm also going to reset my diet at exactly the same time for a much more energy and protein focused diet. Yeah, I think getting down to 15 is certainly on the cards. It's also important to point out we shouldn't use weight as our... It's a nice easy metric, it's a nice broad metric, but that by no means tells the whole picture. But when you've got a lot of weight to lose, it's an easy one to start with. But going to become far more important to measure my body composition rather than the total weight. So I'm nearly at the gym. Not going to be doing much today. Just a little bit of a sweaty Betty, a bit of upper body. My legs are still a little too painful to really get the squats in. And being as in 4 days' time, I'm going to be back in hospital having my bum done, there's not really any point doing much with my legs other than just trying to exercise them a little bit. So there we go. Right, I'm at the gym. Back in a bit. Hey, welcome back. So that was a body, a bit of shoulder. Honestly, did not get much done. It's really odd. And I guess I'm not the only person that's been in this position when you're out of your groove and you don't train well. And then you just find it hard to train, to focus. And you're like, oh, is there any point in even being here? I got a few hundred calories, which is fine. But it's not, it's frustrating. I can't wait to get the surgeries done to get back to my normal routine and really like turn this back on again. But you know what? It's okay. And I'm really not trying to convince myself that not training properly is like, it's fine. But let's be honest, I'm very busy. I got, extremely busy client, lots of work to do. I've got all this surgery going on. I've got, lots of work being done in the house at the moment. Excuses, yada, yada. But I think I'm okay. I think considering I'm having you know, significant cosmetic surgery monthly that requires major anaesthetic. Plus all the other stuff I've got going on, I think I can allow myself to be a little bit slack in the gym. My diet's okay, I'm still losing weight, so you know. Anywho, I've been working on some progression, some growth for cutting the caboose, the stuff that comes next, okay? And I've got lots and lots of ideas. Now, the weight loss side of things and workouts, the workouts are gonna stay. The weight loss and surgery, as you know, is coming to an end. I'm months away from having all my surgery finished, even the plumbing, you know what I'm talking about? All of that is going to be done, finished with soon. So that fountain of content is kind of wrapping up. I'm going to be at the end of that journey. Okay, I'll still have the bodybuilding and the training and the lifestyle and the diety stuff, that's fine. So I'm looking at what alternative things to bring in as content to replace that for the channel. Now, we've got the crazy gadget reviews and the fitness. There's a never-ending supply of that sort of stuff I can keep doing, which is fine. We've got some stuff that I've been trying out already, like makeup hauls, clothing hauls. That's an option that I can bring in and keep in the channel. I've also been toying with slightly more ranty stuff, but I want to do things on unfortunate facts. I've recorded some already, although they need a little more work. But videos which really dig into bull, you know, the sort of bullshit stuff like faith healers and miracle cures and magic potions and herbal diets and, you know, all this bullshit that surrounds us all the time. And I'm thinking of doing a series of videos basically on crap, on nonsense, on I'm surprised they're legal sort of scams. You know, the sort of stuff I mean? Aloe vera diets and I've kind of touched on them and I normally get quite a lot of response. They're a little divisive. I know some people are like, oh my God, you can't dismiss this magic oil drink that I do. But I'm thinking of doing stuff on that. And so that's where I'm at. What do you think? Bear in mind, I'm dropping the technology and I'm not going to be doing gaming, although I've got a new gaming channel starting, you know, other stuff is coming. So I need to keep this channel quite niche. And as I've focused the content more around the weight loss and lifestyle niche, it's grown faster, which is great. But what do you want? Leave your comments below. I'm being cheeky here. I'm asking you to help me decide what the future of the channel will be. But being as it's you who have got this channel where it is, I think it's only fair that you have some say in where it goes next, right? You know? So what do you think? Leave your comments below. What do you think we should do next? Where should the channel go? What sort of content would you like me to cover? And I need to keep it niche. Enough for, you know, the current, you know, two or three videos a week, the current routine. The some stuff's gonna stay. Makeup is almost certainly going to come. I'm really enjoying doing the makeup. And what sort of regular things would you like me to do? This may be my last video blog before I record, because I'm going to Belgium in a couple of days. So this may be the last video blog until I'm recording on the road to Belgium. Exciting! I think I've got one more to do, but maybe not. Whenever I do one of these road trip videos, I know they're really popular. And this one is going to be crazy, a brand new bum. I've got to change the name of the channel for that one, right? For just that one video, because I've gone from cutting the caboose to getting a caboose. Ha! You're all weak. Okay, that's it for this one. Thank you so much for watching. Little bit of a sketchy, sketchy one, I know. There was no real plot with this one. I was just like, there. This is the things. I can't wait to see what you think. I can't wait to read your comments. As always, like, share, subscribe, dislike, all that engagement is good. And I shall see you guys in the very next show. Popping up on the right is the previous video that I put out. And below that somewhere is the video that YouTube thinks you should watch next. See you later. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.